Chris McCusker joins us from the City News Business Center now. Hey, Chris, happy Friday.
Oh, we made it, Cynthia.
Not quite. We're not quite there yet.
That's true.
Okay, yeah. American politicians are in the middle of serious dance right now about the owners with the owners of TikTok.
Yeah.
Is there a chance they could actually ban the app? What is the likelihood?
It's hard to say, but in 270 days, Cynthia, the U.S. says that ByteDance must divest, so sell itself, or it will be banned in the U.S. That is basically the gist of a bill signed into law by the U.S. president. So the Chinese-based owner of TikTok, ByteDance, now preparing to sue the U.S. government. And law professors say the company might actually have a strong case. Really, the overarching theme here is that a TikTok ban is a First Amendment problem, and this issue has been in the U.S. courts a couple of times already. So because of this First Amendment issue, this could suggest an uphill battle in justifying the ban. Now, just to remind everyone, Canada does not have a ban, but devices issued by the federal government cannot use TikTok. So you know Canada's watching what happens in the U.S.
Of course. Now, let's touch on the markets briefly. It was a strong week overall, both here and in the U.S.
Yeah, so the NASDAQ saw its best week so far this year, Cynthia. The TSX also higher this week by about 0.7%. It's down by about the same in the month of April with just a few trading days left. Now, I'm going to go rapid fire on some stocks of note today because really there was a lot of news. Shares in Alphabet hit an all-time high. That company also closed with a market cap above $2 trillion. Microsoft was higher after very strong earnings. Shares in Snap also surged by 30%. At one point today, that company offered a strong sales forecast, which eased concerns about its prospects. The earnings report also resulted in at least one upgrade. You also know that Snap's going to benefit if there is a ban on TikTok. And then shares in Intel going the other way. That stock saw the biggest one-day drop since 2020 on a weak outlook. And Cynthia, one interesting note on Intel's earnings, no mention of artificial intelligence. The other companies that did see a big pop in their stock do have an AI component. So AI is very in, so to speak.
Right. Okay. Finally, the tax deadline, my favorite time of year, is just around the corner. And it certainly isn't an artificial one if you owe the government money.
That is correct. So the deadline is Tuesday. Look at that. The end of April is upon us. An estimated 10 million Canadians still have not filed. Now, how's this for motivation? If you owe money, filing late means a penalty. It's 5% of your balance owing plus 1% of the balance owing for each month your return is late to a maximum of 12 months owe. And if you have filed late and been fined in the past, guess what? Those fines could be higher. No pressure or anything.
No pressure. Get it in. Get it in. All right. Yeah. We all know what those 10 million Canadians are doing this weekend. Hopefully they'll get it in. All right.
Yes.
Chris, thanks for joining us this week.
Okay.
It's been great to have you on board with
us. Yes. Thanks for having me. Have a great weekend.
You too.